Welcome back. You may want to switch up your sunscreen this summer based on new regulations over the ingredients. The FDA proposing changes to the way that they are labeled. So what does this mean for you? Dr. Jennifer Lucas is a dermatologist with the Cleveland Clinic, and she has some insight. So this is interesting because, I mean, we see all the different sunscreens on the shelves each and every year, but what should we be looking for? What's new? You're also talking about ingredients, and there could be up to like 16 different ones we all really don't understand. So like, what's effective and what's not?
So I think the most important part to start with is to make sure it's protecting your skin in the manner you think it does.
Okay.
So I would look for a few things on the bottle. You want it to have a 30 SPF or higher, and you want it to say the words broad spectrum.
Okay.
Beyond that, it being water resistant is also helpful, because if you're in a pool, you're out sweating, it will help keep that sunscreen on your skin and keep you better protected.
Now, talk about the ones, the two, zinc oxide and then a dioxide?
Titanium dioxide,
okay.
Yes. Yeah. So those are physical blockers, and there's a lot of press right now, and there's a lot of interest in the safety of ingredients that are found in sunscreen. So those two are physical blockers, and they tend to be thought of as safe.
Okay.
So you can use this knowing that you're getting good protection and knowing that you're keeping your skin safe.
So if you're really looking into the ingredients, some of us just read the front.
Sure, absolutely.
Right? You know, so if you're really into it, those are the ones to look for. Talk about the getting it into your bloodstream. I never really heard of this. Is that possible?
I mean, there has been some interest or some literature out on this. I think that's still to be found, so I think it's being looked into.
Okay.
And I know there's a lot of fear over putting sunscreen on your skin. As the dermatologist, though, I'm going to tell you, if you don't do it and you don't protect yourself, what I am sure of is you're putting yourself at risk for cancer.
Sure, sure. Now, like the Walgreens brands, the Walmart brand, those are okay if they just say what you...
As long as they have those words on the bottle, broad spectrum, at least 30 SPF. Beyond that, I get asked a lot, what's your favorite sunscreen or what do you recommend? And really, it's what you're willing to put on your body.
Okay.
Nothing works well in a bottle. So I'm happy with what you're willing to put on as long as it says the things that you need to keep you safe.
So what is your perspective on sprays and lotions?
So I
like sprays because they're easy with the kids, but then I feel like once the wind blows, then it's all gone.
Right. So I like people to put a base coat on of a lotion or a cream. Why? Because I know you're getting the amount that I want you to put on. And frankly, no one puts on enough sunscreen. So you need at least a 1 ounce or shot glass. I think we have an image here to take a picture of.
Yeah, John, here, we'll put this right here.
Certainly. So you need at least this amount of sunscreen to cover your body. That's a lot. And so I get asked a lot, is my bottle of sunscreen from the year before good? Well, it might be, but you should be running out of your bottle of sunscreen if you're actually applying this amount.
That's a really good point. So this is what you're saying, a recommendation of how much, which I thought was a lot, because this is kind of a big shot glass, but I guess when you're thinking about your entire body.
Correct.
Right. So talk about the makeup with the SPF. I know as us women, I'm like, oh, I got the makeup on, you know, the foundation that says it has SPF in it. Is that okay?
You know, I like anything additional that you're willing to put on your skin. So I'm okay with makeups that have it in. It's extra protection. But it's still not going to give you, I think, that consistent application that you need to protect yourself. So as women, before we put on our makeup, we do need to put on that layer of protective sunscreen so that we know we're protecting ourselves and staying young and beautiful, which is what we want our makeup to do for us anyway.
Exactly. And talk about the protectant clothing.
Yeah.
I have my son who's two, and I just put the shirts on, you know, the swim shirts.
So I like protective clothing, broad brim hats, long sleeve shirts, long pants, and sunglasses. You need to protect your eyes as well.
But do you need to put the sunscreen under these?
I do recommend you do. The more protection that you get, truly the better. Now, in young infants, this is the best way to protect them. We want to protect them with those clothing, seek shade, avoid the midday sun. These are important things to keep yourself safe.
Yeah. Very good. Very good stuff. Thank you, Dr. Lucas.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's a good reminder. You know, we're halfway through, you know, the summer and stuff, and we forget, especially as a parent.
Right.
You're very concerned about them, you forget about yourself.
You do. So. And with these beautiful days out there, we want to be outside, but we want to be safe while we're doing it.
Thank you, doctor.
You're welcome.
Appreciate
Thank you so much.